Hello, my name is Vijay Pratap Singh and I am pursuing PhD from MIT Allahabad. In next 10 minutes, I will discuss about the three-phase star and delta network. So before starting, let us look what is the three-phase system and how it looks like. So three-phase system is generally used for the transmitting of the bulk amount of power from one end to another end due to its several advantages over the single-phase system in the terms of the efficiency, cost and many more. So let us look what is the three-phase system. So three-phase system, basically we have drawn here the three single-phase source with low resistance R. So each sources are not electrically connected to each other. To make it three-phase system, we can see that the returning path of the each conductor are same, so we can remove it and club it together to make a three-phase system. So it will look like this way, and this will be on the neutral points. So if the load R, if the load resistance R is same for every phases, then the sum of instantaneous current IA, IB plus IC is equal to zero. And another important thing for the three-phase system is that every phase should have the 120 degree phase shift with respect to each other. So we have the EA here. EB will lag EA by 120 degree and EC will lag EB by 120 degree in this way. Now, the two major type of circuit under the three-phase system is the star and delta network. So let us look one by one. Firstly, we will look star and then delta network. So start with the star network. So these two type of circuits are different from each other from their configuration points, and also the relationship between the line parameters and the phase parameters. So star circuit is basically looks like a, like say star, or you can say the alphabetically letter YE, WYE. So let us draw the star circuit. So I have considered here a load resistance R in a star fashion, like this way. This RRR, load resistance, and let us take a line, A line, A phase. This is for your B, and this is your for C, and this is of course, this is your the neutral point. So in the star circuits, the similar end of the each conductor are joined at a common point known as the neutral point. So here we have the two things, the line parameters A, B, C, and we have the phase parameters. So these are the phase circuits. The line and between neutral, these are called the phase circuits. So we have to establish the relation between the line parameters and the phase parameters. So let us take, these are the line voltages. Line voltage is basically the voltage between the two lines. That is your EAB, this is your EBC, and this is your ECA. So the line current from IA, IB and this IC. Similarly, the phase current is IAB, IBB and ICB. These are the phase currents. So let us take the effective value of magnitude voltage here, that is your the let's also take, this is A, B and C. So this will be the your EAN, this will be your EBN and this will be your ECN. So in order to get the relationship between the phase parameters and line parameters and phase parameters, so let us first take that the line current IA is flowing into the phase circuit. So in the case of a star connection, line current is same as your the phase current. What about the line voltage and the phase voltage? So let us take first two lines, AB lines, and apply a KVL here. So once we apply a KV here, so we will get EAB, we will get this circuit. So EAB is equal to your EAN minus EBN. This is your line, these are the phase. So let us draw the phasor diagram. So EAN will be in a what direction? This will be your EAN. EBM is 120 degree apart from each other. This will be your EBM, and this is your ECM will be in this direction. This will be your ECM. So what will be the negative? What will be the minus EBM? This is your EN. So minus EBM will be in this direction, and this will be your minus EB. So this will be your EAB, the effective value of magnitude, and this angle will be 60 degree, then this angle will be the 30 degree. So after some mathematical calculation, we can establish the relationship between the line voltage and phase voltage, and what we get, that is your E line is equal to root 3 times your E phase voltage. So these are the relationship between the line parameters and phase parameters. And what about the line current? Line current is same as your phase current. So another circuit, let us look about what is the delta and how it different from the star connection. So delta configuration is basically, it is by the Greek letter delta. So in the delta configuration, conductors are arranged in a ring fashion such that the opposite end of the conductors are joined at a point. These are the opposite end of the conductor are joined at a point. So we have here, we have a line. This is your for B. And similarly, this is for your C. So similarly, this is your the line voltage EAB, this is your the line voltage EBC, and this is your ECA. So here this is your the line current IA, line current IB, line current IC. So similarly, this is your ABC. So this will be your EAB. This will be your EBC, this will be your ECA, and the value of phase current is ICP, this will be the IAP, and this will be the IBP. So in order to get a relationship between the line parameters and the phase parameters, here we can see that if we take the two lines AB, so the two lines is directly applied here, all the resistances are on. So from in the delta circuits, the line voltage is same as the phase voltage. So EL is equal to your E phase. So what about the line current and phase current? So in order to get a line current and phase current, let us draw a phasor diagram. So EAB in this direction, EBC will be in this direction, this will be your EAB, this will be your EBC, and this will be the ECA. Since it is a resistive load, since all the current IAP, ICP, IBP in the phase with IBC, EAB and ECA. And similar way, if we do the some mathematical calculation, we will found that the line current is equal to 2 times phase current cos 30 after mathematical calculation. So we get the line current is equal to root 3 times your the phase current. So we have established the relationship between the star and delta connection. So let us conclude some interesting points. So for a star connection, star, and here is your delta. So in star connection, we get the line current is equal to phase current, and your the EL is equal to root 3 times your EPH, phase current, phase voltage. So what about the power? So power is equal to VPH IPH. Per phase power is equal to VPH into IPH. Normally the power is expressed in the line parameters, and for the three phase system it will be multiplied by 3 VPH, and put the value of VPH IPH by star connection and delta connection, and we will get P is equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. Cos phi is for the inductive and capacitive root. So another important thing is that if for the application purpose, if any motor is connected in a star fashion, then its speed will be reduced, because your the phase voltage will be the 1/3 of the line voltage, so the motor speed will be slow. Whereas in the case of delta connection, the phase same line voltage is applied to the phase voltage, hence the motor speed will be increased. Due to the lower available voltage in a phase, the lower insulation will be required. So saving of the copper material is used, where in the case of a delta, the higher insulation is required. And another important thing is that it is used for the transmission of the power and typical to be used in our the power system, whereas in delta connection it will be used for the distribution purpose and for the industry application, and generally typical to be used in the power system. So this is a brief discussion about three phase star and delta network. Thank you.